Since our last update, I have been able to confirm the identity of four of the five victims in this case. Three of the confirmed deceased in this incident have been identified as Raymonde Joseph, Carla Merhige, and Lisa Merhige. The fourth victim, who is currently at St. Mary's Hospital, has been identified as Patrick McKnight. What we do know at this particular time is the suspect has been identified as the brother of two of our victims that have been confirmed deceased. We have currently sought out the assistance from multiple agencies to assist in the location of the suspect. At this particular point, he's still at large, considered armed and dangerous. The identity of the fifth victim will be released shortly. We do know that it is a juvenile, and we're still waiting for additional information on that.
Can you tell us the other agencies you guys are working with right now?
Right now, we're working with the Miami-Dade. We're working with the FBI, and obviously with our agency here to locate the suspect.
Can we get those names again, just so our viewers have that?
Sure. Raymonde Joseph, Carla Merhige, Lisa Merhige, and Patrick McKnight.
Could you tell us a little bit about the suspect and how people can help find him?
Well, at this particular point, what we do know is what he's driving, and that is a 2007 blue Toyota Camry four-door, and it has a Florida license plate of W427JT. That's all we have about the suspect at this time, outside of what I've already told you. So.
And what was he doing here tonight, just in town for Thanksgiving? Or?
From what I can gather at this particular point, it was a family gathering for Thanksgiving, yes.
Do you think he's going down to Miami?
I don't have any information concerning that. Our concerns are right now locating him. He potentially could be here locally. But as I mentioned before, seeking the assistance from Miami-Dade, there is a potential for that, yes.
You believe he's armed and dangerous with a gun, I imagine?
Yes, yes.
And tell me, are you tracking a cell phone or anything in terms of his whereabouts?
All I can tell you at this particular point is that we're working with the FBI on that.
And tell us how the victims were related to each other.
The suspect is the brother of two of our victims that we've been able to confirm at this particular time.
How did this all start? Anything more on what happened here? What can you tell us about that?
I don't have specifics as to what transpired in the residence prior to the shooting. So that's still in the works as far as our preliminary investigation. As this develops, I can definitely give you additional information about what exactly took place.
So. Still believe it's domestic related, something inside the home is where it all began?
Apparently so at this particular point, yes.
And do you have the ages of the victims as well?
No, I do not. I do not have the ages of the victims at this time. I'm still working on further information about the victims, but at this point I was able to get, you know, gather their names for you. So.
And do you know what type of weapon was used?
No, I do not. I don't have any additional information about the investigation other than what I've given you so far. So.
Three dead, two injured. Are any surgery taking place?
I don't have any information concerning what's taking place at St. Mary's. I was just able to confirm that we do have three deceased and two additional victims.
Did anyone see the car leave? Are there any witnesses who perhaps saw a little bit more outside the house?
No, we don't have any specific witnesses here, but that's why we're reaching out to the public for their assistance. Maybe if you do see this vehicle on the roadway, to please contact us immediately.
Can you tell me, it seemed like the bullets were just sprayed in the room, or did it seem methodical?
I have no specific information concerning the crime scene at this particular time.
Again, could you just repeat how people can help and what you're looking for?
Well, obviously, we're looking for the suspect. The suspect has been identified as Paul Michael Merhige. His date of birth is 9/10/74. We do know that he has an address potentially out of Miami, and he's driving a blue 2007 Toyota Camry four-door with a Florida license plate of W427JT. Anybody with information concerning this individual is urged to contact us immediately.
And show us his picture just one last time so we've got that up for everyone to see. All right, so Victor, that seems to be the latest here from this live press conference.